I didn't study it along the line of our wanting to design a house for 3D print. It was an exercise to simply design a family home. It wasn't intended to be a technology showcase. My goal for designing this house was to create an architecturally exciting, livable home for the family. We have stayed here since 25 years ago, and the house got a bit old, a bit tired, and needing a lot of repair. And during the COVID time, there was a lot of concerns for labor and how we would like to make the building more buildable using less resources, labor, carbon footprint. And I thought 3D print could be a solution. It was intentional because we wanted to pitch 3D printing process as a potential mainstream construction technology. I wanted the technology and the 3D printing process to fit what a conventional house requires. We were concerned of the fact that the house is a very deep and square house, and the center of the house has always been a bit dark. As architect, I want to bring in light to the center of the house. The quality of light is very interesting. As we speak, even under this cone, it has gotten a bit darker, a bit lighter, creating a lot of emotion, a lot of experience. And we cite the dining table under this cone because for me, dining table is where we spend a lot more time interacting, and it's more important space than even the living room. There were moments in the whole construction process that I start to question whether are we doing the right thing, making such a big leap. This being the first 3D printed house, there are a lot of challenges and a lot of learning in the whole process. We started printing the cone, which is not vertical, and it is lean in, and it was difficult for the print to be printed at a reasonable speed without it slumping. So in particular for the cone, we printed small little sections in a very controlled environment, let it dry, and then stack them up like we would a brick. The next stage of 3D printing will be using steel fiber infused concrete, and that print itself will become the structural element. It's ready technology that's available, but that will involve a fair bit of acceptance and adoption by the building construction authority. The design process of the house took about 10 months, and the construction was about 14 to 16 months. Conventional construction would take about similar time. But the hope is when it matures and when this is applied properly, it will cut the construction time down by maybe 30%. 3D printing was first introduced to Singapore in 2019. I believe HDB brought the technology in and see how it could help the whole public housing industry. It's still being used to print street furniture, small elements, and at most a single-story toilet somewhere. and it has not gone very far. What I wanted to put forward is the proposition that 3D printing technology should adopt itself to become part of the whole construction industry. My hope and my dream will be that at some point in time, in a normally designed building and during the tender process, the contractor will propose a 3D printing as a value engineering proposition, as a cost saving proposition, and elevate this to become an advantage.